From direct to garment to UV printing to all over printing, creating design print files can seem overwhelming, especially if you need to gain experience. So we made this video to add to your print-on-demand toolkit so you can spend more time creating the perfect print file and less time worrying about how and what to do. In this video, I'll share 8 things I wish I'd known before creating print files when I first started with Printful. Let's get started. If you're not a Photoshop expert, that's all right. It's your time to shine and unleash your creativity because Printful's Design Maker is free and easy to use. To create your product, select any item from Printful's product catalog and click Create Product Template. Now you can choose the fulfillment technique, colors, and sizes you want. Afterward, you can upload your design and seamlessly edit it with clip art, text, or assets from a premium image library. If this is your first time using the Design Maker, check out this video on how to use it, where you can learn everything you need to know about creating your designs. I'll leave a link in the description. If you have some experience with graphics design software like Adobe Photoshop, Illustrator, or Procreate, look for the print file guidelines for the specific product you want to design. Different types of products have different print sizes. They can vary from as small as a phone case with a print size of 2.93 by 6.1 inches to as big as a blanket with a whopping 62.5 by 83 inch print area. You can find the print file guidelines in the product tab while designing in the Design Maker. Or if you're navigating the product catalog, in the description under the File Guidelines tab. The file guidelines come in PNG format and PSD for Photoshop. Most graphic design software can open PSD files, but in case the one you use doesn't, you can set your file dimensions to the size of the print area, the resolution to 300, the color profile to sRGB ICE6, and import the PNG version of the guideline. Here's a bonus tip for those working in pixels. To get the correct pixel size, all you have to do is multiply the width by 300 and the length by 300. Why 300? Because this will determine how many pixels per inch, or DPI, your file will have when placed in a 12 by 16 inch print area. So for a unisex shirt, the front print size is 12 by 16 inches, and the pixel dimensions will be 3,600 by 4,800 pixels. What file type should I save my print files in? Stick to the basics. And by the basics, we're talking about saving your files as PNG and JPEG. When you save or export your print files, you want to avoid exporting them as a PDF, Photoshop files, or Illustrator files. These file types can sometimes cause issues with printing hidden layers that you might not want to see. For direct-to-garment printing, use PNG, as this file type supports a transparent background and will just print the design. You can choose between PNG and JPEG for UV-printed and all-over-printed products. It depends on what you plan to print. If you want your logo or a small design to be printed and not cover the entire area, PNG will keep the background transparent. Both will work if you plan to cover the whole print area. However, JPEG will be the go-to choice for keeping the file size small. Keeping the file size small will be important when you print on larger all-over print products like blankets and flags. The maximum file size is 200 megabytes, which won't be too difficult to reach when saving your print files in the PNG format. When it comes to file resolution, size matters. In this case, one size does not fit all. File resolution refers to how many pixels or dots per inch your design file has. If you try to place a print file made for a phone case on a blanket, you will have serious pixelation issues, which can ruin your brand reputation if your customer is disappointed in the print quality. And we don't want that. When you upload your design to a Printful product, in the Layers panel, you'll see a print quality measure that will change when you scale your design. If you make it bigger, you're stretching the file across a bigger area, which reduces the number of pixels per inch. The less DPI there is, the more blurry or pixelated the print will look. We require a minimum of 150 DPI for direct-to-garment and all-over print products, but for best results, aim for 300 DPI across all your products. When we talk about full bleed, we mean an image that extends right to the edges of what's being printed. If you're designing for canvas prints or all over printed products, you must ensure it covers the whole printing area. Otherwise, you might end up with parts of the product that don't have any design, which isn't ideal. Keeping the crucial parts of your design within the printing area for all over print products will prevent them from getting cut off or hidden in the seams when sewn together. The safe print area can be seen in the Design Maker and in the file guidelines. Lastly, double check your work by checking the mock-up view to see how your design will look when it's printed. Make sure to remove your design's background completely. If elements are not completely erased from a print file within your graphic design software, they'll show up when printed, even if they're only 1% visible. For DTG products, we print a white underbase under the design, which helps the print be more saturated against the color of the garment. If your print file has elements not entirely erased, they will show because of the white underbase. After removing the background from your picture, double check for any leftover bits around the object. You can do this by putting a brightly colored background behind the object or duplicating the layer with the design a few times. Alternatively, you can try the background removal tool within the Design Maker. With this tool, an AI program will remove the background automatically for you. The background removal tool works best for high contrast images with simple backgrounds. In most cases, the background will be erased successfully if the object has a clear outline. When selling custom print-on-demand products online, you want to ensure customers have a good experience from the start, so they'll want to return. Part of creating a good experience is ensuring the product they receive looks just like what they saw on their screens. However, a few things can change how colors turn out when it comes to printing. The color of printed designs is influenced by different factors, like the item's material, its original color, the use of a white base layer, or the color settings applied during the design process. Check out our video to learn everything you need to know about color correcting. I'll leave a link in the description so you can check it out. If the design you print is similar to the color of the garment, you might run into issues with the print being barely visible. Consider contrasting colors with the garment to make your design stand out. The mock-up representation may differ in color and contrast from the final printed product, so if you're experimenting outside of these suggestions, you can check the results by ordering a sample to review the outcome. If you need assistance with your design print files, our dedicated customer support team is here to help. Feel free to reach out to us at support@printful.com. I hope you found this video helpful. Make sure to come back for more exciting and useful tips and tutorials. If you have any questions, pop them in the comments.